Birds do it. Bees do it. But in the avian world, reproduction takes a surprising turn. It's a tale of evolutionary ingenuity, genetic trickery, and a nifty multitasking organ. Now, most male birds don't have what we traditionally call a penis. Instead, they perform what's known as a cloacal kiss. This isn't as romantic as it sounds. It's simply when a male bird ejects sperm from his cloaca directly into the female's cloaca. The cloaca is a multitasking marvel. Derived from the Latin word for sewer, the cloaca is the Swiss Army knife of bird anatomy. This single opening handles it all: waste excretion, egg laying, and yes, copulation. Efficiency at its finest. But why did most birds evolve without a penis? Well, the jury's still out on that one. Scientists have various theories, but the definitive purpose of this penile absence remains as elusive as the dodo bird. As for how it happens, researchers from the University of Florida and other institutions made an exciting breakthrough. They discovered that most landfowl actually do start developing penis precursors as embryos. But then, nature pulls a now you see it, now you don't trick. A gene called BMP4, bone morphogenetic protein 4, swoops in like a party pooper. The gene initiates a series of biochemical reactions, resulting in the gradual deterioration and disappearance of cells that would otherwise form the penis. As the embryo grows, the penis shrinks, leaving adult birds with just a modest protophallus. To prove this wasn't just a wild goose chase, the researchers blocked the BMP4 signaling pathway in chicken embryos. Lo and behold, these chicks developed full-fledged penises. But let's not be too hasty in blaming Mother Nature for this avian emasculation. The BMP4 gene isn't just part of bird development. It's actually a crucial player in embryonic development across many species, including humans. In our own species, BMP4 is a bit of an overachiever. It's involved in the formation of bones and cartilage, organ development, and even plays a role in eye and hair color. This discovery not only sheds light on avian anatomy, but also highlights the fascinating ways in which genes can be repurposed throughout evolution. One species bone builder is another species phallus phaser. But not all birds are members of the snowpecker club. Waterfowl like geese and ducks, as well as ostriches and emus, proudly sport some bizarrely shaped phalluses. But unlike mammalian penises with internal channels, bird penises transport sperm along their surface. This unique delivery method is likely an adaptation to their rapid mating behaviors. When you're trying to propagate the species, every second counts. As we wrap up this feathered foray into fowl phalluses, remember, in the avian world, it's not about the size of the worm, but the effectiveness of the beak.